The uncertainty inherent in weather forecasting conjures images of dartboards, dice, or magician's tricks. In reality, National Weather Service, Charleston, South Carolina, meteorologists prepare weather forecasts 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, 365 days a year, by employing a more scientific approach. This short video will outline this systematic forecast process. Forecasters then evaluate the large amount of data which constantly flows into the Charleston, South Carolina Weather Forecast Office. This data includes upper air observations, satellite and radar imagery, as well as surface observations such as airport and marine buoy observations. Forecasters also spend considerable time reviewing the latest computer simulations of the atmosphere, known as computer forecast models. Computers rapidly solve complex mathematical problems to illustrate how our three-dimensional atmosphere could change in space and time. These models provide forecasters with a critical roadmap for conditions expected over the next few hours through at least the next week. A meteorologist combines this roadmap with experience to produce the forecast. Most forecast models are produced by supercomputers located in the United States and around the world. So, if supercomputers can forecast the weather, what is the role of the meteorologist?
We think of the change in weather much in the same way you might think of a puzzle. It's an incomplete puzzle, scattered all over the place. And what we have to do is we have to put the puzzle together. Now, supercomputers help us out with that by doing a lot of calculations very quickly. It's very mathematical. A lot of math crunching, a lot of number crunching has to go on. Supercomputers can do that very quickly, much more quickly than the human mind can. Where humans come in to the equation is we have to decide, once the computers have given us a list of possible solutions to the puzzle. You can put the puzzle together this way, you can put it together this way. We decide which one is the most likely solution, what's most likely to occur in the future. And that's what we do better than computers. We make decisions.
A meteorologist can effectively decide which redundant, time-consuming tasks are best left to computers and which tasks require the intuition and expertise of a human forecaster. In this way, forecasters can pay the most attention to phenomena that will produce the greatest impact, such as severe thunderstorms. In reality, this process can become quite challenging during complex weather patterns. After reviewing and assimilating data, including computer forecast models and prioritizing forecast problems, National Weather Service Charleston, South Carolina meteorologists prepare forecasts utilizing software known as the Graphical Forecast Editor. Meteorologists use this graphic software to create and modify forecasts of myriad elements, such as precipitation chances or type, temperatures and wind direction or speed, and rainfall amounts. Many of these forecast elements are important to specialized users, such as mariners, wildland firefighters, and pilots. NWS Charleston, South Carolina forecasters then determine when to raise public awareness regarding hazardous weather, such as strong winds, dangerous marine conditions, winter precipitation, and dense fog. Using specific criteria, forecasters issue watches, warnings, and advisories to apprise the public of expected or imminent hazardous weather.
So if we're expecting a particularly dangerous situation, such as a tropical storm or a hurricane to impact the area, or a big outbreak of severe thunderstorms, we would then work closely with the media and brief them to make sure that they can brief the public and keep them aware. We also are in constant contact with emergency managers so that they can make decisions regarding public safety.
Every day, National Weather Service meteorologists apply scientific reasoning to produce weather forecasts. These forecasts can help you plan your activities and keep you safe. For more information, visit us on the web or through social media.